In our first Adobe lesson, we're going to learn about Adobe InDesign. Adobe InDesign is used for page layout, and you'll find that it's useful for flyers, brochures, magazine pages, even small things like business cards, postcards. In this lesson, we'll learn some basic skills about how to use pictures and text in InDesign. These will include using the content grabber, guidelines, and the all-important Eyedropper tool. Before you start the lesson, make sure to download and unzip the lesson1.zip file that's linked above this video. If you need help, let me know. When you start InDesign, we'll open a letter-sized page. That's a standard 8.5x11 page, just like a regular piece of paper. Start InDesign and click Create New. Select Letter and then click Create. We're going to put a picture on this page and we will learn how to move, resize, and crop the picture. So we'll go to the File menu and select Place. Open the folder that you downloaded and unzipped and locate the drawing.jpg file. Select that file. Then you'll see a thumbnail of the picture. Click that on your page and the whole picture will show up. The picture has a blue outline around it. This is the frame of the picture. The frame and the picture are separate things. We think of the picture as being inside the frame. So if you grab the upper left corner of the frame and move that dot, it will change the size of the frame. The picture will still be the same size, but the frame is now smaller. So we've cropped the picture so we only see part of it. Now go to your Properties panel, click the three little dots underneath the Transform section, and then type in 60 for the horizontal scale. The horizontal and vertical scale are linked. So the horizontal and vertical dimensions of your picture will both change by 60%. The picture is now smaller. Grab the lower right corner of the picture frame and drag it. Now the frame is bigger than that side of the picture. Then grab the upper left-hand corner of the frame and drag that as well. Now the whole frame is larger than the picture. Press Shift and Command if you're on a Mac, or Shift and Control if you're on a PC, and drag the corner. Now both the frame and the picture change size. Open the Object menu, point to Fitting, and select Fit Frame to Content. This will make the frame exactly the same size as the picture. Okay, now we'll delete the picture and we'll place it again. So go to the File menu, choose Place, and find your picture.
And this time we're going to pretend that we need the picture to be in a frame that's a certain size. I'm going to make the frame much smaller than the picture, but I don't want to see this part. I can use the circle in the middle, which we call the content grabber, to move the picture around inside the frame. So click on the content grabber and slide your picture over. Now you see a different part of the picture. Click on the content grabber once and don't slide, and you'll see this dark orange frame. This is the actual size of the picture. We can use this to resize or rotate our picture within the frame. So if I go to one of the corners and I hold my cursor near there, I see a rotate tool and I can rotate my picture in the frame. I can even grab a corner and resize the picture in the frame and then move it around as well until I get what I want.
Now we'll see how guides work and how they can help us organize our pages. So delete your picture.
InDesign starts with a default margin, which is a kind of guide. It's always a pinkish purple color around the edge of the page. This doesn't print, and it's actually not important. You can put things on either side of it or across it, and it'll all work out just fine. Guides are lines that you add to help you organize the things on the page, and you get them by pulling out from the ruler. So if you click on a ruler and drag across to your page, you'll see a blue line. These also don't print. And we're going to use this line to help us arrange some copies of our picture. So we'll get our picture again by going to File, Place, picking our picture, and then we'll click our thumbnail right next to the line. Okay, this snaps the picture to the line. You can see the picture's so big that it goes off the edge of the page. We're going to make it a lot smaller. We can do that with our... Now we're going to make some more copies of the picture and have them line up underneath it. We'll go to the Edit menu and click Copy. And then we'll go to the Edit menu and we'll click Paste in Place. This puts a copy of the picture right on top of the other one. Then click and drag it down. It will also snap to the guide. And if I go to Edit and click Paste in Place again, I get another copy of the picture above on top of the first one. And if I drag this down, as I move down, you'll see that I can have them line up. I can also notice there's small green arrows between the pictures that show me that the space between the first and second is the same as the space between the second and third. This is called distributing the pictures equally, so the spaces between them are the same. You can also do this later, if let's say we take this picture and move it away like that, by selecting all the pictures and going to your window menu, go to Objects and Layout and pick a line. And here we have distribute options. So if I want to distribute the vertical centers, I do that and I get equal spacing between all pictures again. I can also add guidelines after I've placed the pictures to help me line up other things later. So if I pull a guideline from the top and bring it to the bottom of the first picture, you'll notice that it snaps there. Guides also snap on centers of things. If I take one to the center of the second picture, it will snap on the center line for that as well.
Guides are very useful because they help us line things up and they make our pages look much more organized and professional. Now we'll add some words to our page and we'll learn how some of the text tools work.
Select the T in your toolbar, which is the type tool. And then we'll drag a box next to the top picture. This box is actually a frame. InDesign uses frames for text as well as pictures. This is a text frame. Okay, let's zoom in so we can see more detail here. And your text box has a blinking line in it. That's your cursor for typing. If we type some words, they show up in the box. And then if we double click on a word, we'll select the whole word. And if we triple click, we'll select the whole line. With the line selected, we're going to increase the size of the letters by using a key command. So it's Shift Command or Shift Control if you're on PC, and then the period key. Each time you press the period key, the letters get bigger. If they get too big, you can press the comma key while you're still holding Shift Command or Shift Control, and your letters will get smaller. And we can change the spacing between the letters as well as their size. If we go to the Properties panel and click on our character settings, the VA with the arrow underneath both of them is what we call tracking, and that will make all the letters closer or further apart. So if we go to 25, they spread apart. If we go to negative 50, they get really close. We can also adjust the space individually. If we click between two letters, between the C and the K here, and we use the kerning setting, which is next to the tracking, and adjust that, we can add space between letters to make it more, to make it all look better. And right now everything's pretty close together. So we will back off on this setting to something that looks better. Okay, click the selection tool to see the frame for the text again, and then click on that and slide it down so that your letters sit on the guideline. With the text frame selected, you can change the font, the size, and the spacing without actually selecting the words inside, as long as you want all of them to be changed the same way. So for now, I'm going to have the text frame selected. I'm going to open the font menu. And I will choose Arial and bold. It no longer fits in the box on one line, so I'll use my shift command or shift control comma to make it smaller.
Okay, at this point, my text is slightly above the guideline. Instead of using the tool to drag it down, I will just click down arrow on my keypad, and it will move down to sit nicely on that guideline. The Eyedropper tool is a very important and very powerful tool in InDesign. It picks up color, just like its name suggests, but it also picks up a lot more things, too. Let's take a look at how the Eyedropper works.
The Eyedropper tool lives underneath the color theme tool. Two-finger tap on your trackpad or Control or Command click on color theme tool to see the menu and then pick the Eyedropper tool. Our text box is still selected, so we'll click the Eyedropper tool on the green apple to add that color to our text. Except that's not what happened. It actually added that color to the box. That's because the fill color is what's picked at the bottom of our toolbox. Let's undo this. We'll go to Edit and Undo to get back to where we were. And we want the color to go into the letters. So we'll pick the little T that's underneath the color boxes. Now we click our Eyedropper tool again, and we click our apple. The color goes into the letters. Press Command and click somewhere on the page to deselect everything. Now pick the Eyedropper tool again and click on the orange color. Take your Eyedropper tool and drag it across the letters. This changes the letters to the orange color, but it also gives them a black outline. I don't like the black outline, and that's there because the color swatches at the bottom of the tool panel show orange as the fill color and black as the stroke or outline color. If I want to get rid of the black, I need to open up the color box below those two by two-finger tapping or control or command clicking on it and picking none. So notice I brought the stroke color forward by clicking on it. Then I click none. And now when I take my Eyedropper and run it across these letters, they have an orange fill without the black outline. Select the text tool and draw another text box. In this box, we will write drawing and coloring. Get the Eyedropper tool again. Click it on one of the letters in Back to School, and then drag it across drawing and coloring. And it gives all of the attributes from Back to School to drawing and coloring. So not just the color and the outline, but the font and the size as well.
Okay. This makes the Eyedropper tool very powerful and very useful. Because you can pick up the entire style from one thing and then apply it to something else. The Eyedropper tool will help you get repetition in your designs. So remember, the Eyedropper tool is your friend.